Paweł Pawlikowski was bored with cinema's tricks. Close-ups, handheld camera, on-the-nose music, all postures and pretend emotions, the Polish-born UK-based director told me on the release of his fourth feature. Coming after a personally fraught, extended professional silence, Ida was a restless attempt to jumpstart both career and love for film. Set in early 1960s Poland, Ida follows Anna, a young novitiate soon to take her vows. Before she does, she is encouraged to meet her aunt and only living relative, Wanda, a hard-living former state prosecutor, who tells her that, in fact, Anna is Ida Lebenstein, a Jew whose family were killed during the war in mysterious circumstances. And so Anna and Wanda set out to uncover this dark family secret, which will profoundly impact both their lives. The plot could readily suggest a fast-paced thriller, perhaps even a revenge saga, but that disregards Pawlikowski's habitual interests and, here, subversive ambitions. His earlier features are intimate, atmospheric, character-based stories, often throwing two disparate, desperate people together. And while a documentary background informs his work, it's realized with a keen, distinctive artistry. Ida strips this aesthetic down even further. Pawlikowski experimented with a monochrome, almost photographic form. The camera rarely moves. Entire scenes play out in locked-off shots. Characters are effectively contained, held by imposed social or innate personal restraints within this unyielding world. Given what Anna and Wanda learn about their family's fate, it also evokes a country trapped by its guilt and unable to truly move on until it acknowledges complicity in past sins. Pawlikowski does something else with his squarer 4:3 Academy ratio frame that's unique. He tilts his shot slightly higher, so there's frequently what the industry would call a large dead space above his characters' heads. But in Ida, given the mystery hanging over these characters and their own spiritual and emotional turmoil, questioning overarching authorities and their roles within it, this dead space comes alive. It literally serves a higher purpose. Yet when Ida herself starts to break out and find her own way, the camera work shifts too. Now it starts to reflect her different perception of and position in her world. One might argue that liberation through experimentation drive character and filmmaker alike. Pawlikowski gambled on unknown collaborations. Young DOP Lukasz Zal took over the cinematography on the second day of shooting and found his innovative, stylized imagery justly acclaimed. Lead Agata Trzebukowska, found in a Warsaw cafe, had never acted before. But her alert expressiveness embodies Anna's slow-burn self-discovery. Ida is a dark film about guilt and faith, regret and loss, but one so beautifully elegant and brutally honest can never be a dour one. Pawlikowski recognizes a wider, positive cultural awakening too, the stirring of Poland's vibrant early 60s jazz scene, for example. The reinvigoration of a first shoot in his native land and the rapturous critical reception, including an Oscar, is evident. And it shows, as with Ida herself, the importance of connecting with one's true identity, no matter how painful. For the risk is worth the reward. A renewal of deeply personal, even creative, vows.